Hello, class.
Hello.
Hi, Tom. Hi, Bobby. How are you doing?
Good. Fabulous. Can't wait to learn.
Right.
Oh, my God. I am so excited to do that.
You guys are pumped. Yeah. So, we are going to learn today a little bit of work on linear graphs. And when I say linear graphs, what kind of graphs am I talking about?
Clue in the first four letters.
Yeah. To do
straight lines.
Okay, and that's kind of important. So linear is just for straight lines. And a key thing I want to sort of kind of make clear and remind people of that literally straight lines can be made in Euclidean geometry by just joining two points. Okay? Any two points create a straight line. Mm-hmm. And all those points have got an equation related to them. I think that's something that we're going to be looking at today. Equation of a line, I feel you guys might know. What is it? Anyone?
Y
equals. Yes, I got the easy one.
Go on.
Mx.
X. Oh, hello.
Apparently, we're acting this out. Plus. Yeah. See how plus. Just, like.
Plus C.
It's almost like like the YMCA, nearly.
No.
Oh, yeah. YMCA. So, as thank you very much, that's wonderful. We have our, just as we are aware, if I were to draw a quick axis like this, our horizontal is RX,
yeah.
And our vertical is... Him and his football is our y, and that's kind of a key thing to be aware. So it's to do with these axes. M is for gradient, which is our slope, mm-hmm. And how steep or how shallow a line is. And I kind of remember it as the French word monte, which is to climb.
Nice.
That's what I've heard. That's what the origins are.
For mountain,
climbing a mountain. Yeah. Lovely.
Yes.
So and that's to do with your slope. And then the C, this is our Y intercept, okay, and that is where it crosses our y axis, okay. And so these things are what you need to kind of name a line. So if we have a look at this example on our graph, and you both see, mm-hmm. So what is our y intercept on this line?
That is going through 1 on
Brilliant.
The y-axis.
Fantastic. So our C is equal to 1. Okay? So our equation is going to be something like y equals, we haven't got our m yet, x, and then plus 1. Okay? So that's the first part, mm-hmm. Right? So if we look now at this line, what's the C for this one?
So going across that minus 3.
So our C is equal to minus 3. So our equation for this line will be y equals something, we haven't got our m yet,
mm-hmm. Yeah.
x, and then minus 3. And that's it's as simple as that.
Yeah.
So when you find your y-intercept, you're literally saying where it crosses the y-axis.
Yeah.
Simple.
Yeah.
Okay? So we're going to come back to this in a minute. So now we're going to look at the idea of the gradient. Okay? So if we look back at this example here, the gradient is how steep our line is, right? So what that kind of means is for every one you go across, how many do you go up? So for this line, if we start at this point 1, where the y-intercept is, if we go along our x-axis 1, how many up are we going?
2.
So it's 2 for a y, and then so our change in y divided by our change in x is how we work out the gradient. So our m for this one is 2 over 1, which is 2. So the equation of our line is this. Make sense?
Yeah,
it does.
Right, so if we have a look at this one, let's go along a bit further. So if I say here and here. So what is our change in y?
1, 2, it looks like.
And then what's our change in x?
That's also 2.
2. So 2 over 2. So our gradient is equal to 1. So that's effectively 1x take away 3. But do we need the 1?
No.
Just x.
Invisible.
Why is he? Okay. So this is how we work out the equation of a line. So what do you notice about the lines on this?
That one's steeper than that one.
Yep.
So I'm going to say that must have a larger gradient.
Brilliant, wonderful. And then compared to this.
But these ones are going in the opposite because these are heading towards the top right-hand corner. These are heading towards the top left-hand.
So they're kind of going. Can you see the lines are effectively going in opposite directions?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Let's have a look at this one now. Okay. Slight change because the line is going in a different direction. So our intercept is what?
Three.
Easy. Yeah. Simple. So plus three. And now our gradient is slightly different because for this our change from 1 to 2 on our x-axis is positive 1. For this one the direction is going the opposite way. So we're going from 2 to 1. So we're taking away. So this is minus 1. So what's the gradient for this?
So as we go minus 1 and then we go up 1.
There we go, so minus 1. So this is minus 1, 1. Yeah. So minus 1 divided by 1 is?
Minus 1.
And so that's just
minus X.
Minus X. Done?
Feeling confident.
So.
That's pretty much the basics right there.
Gradients, intercepts. Boom.
Well done.
You guys have been great.
Y,
mx plus C.
I'm not.
Thank you, Miss Susan, for introducing us to the world of the equation of a line. Now we're going to look at, can we work out the equation of a line with just having 2 points?
I was hoping he would drop that there.
So we've got 2 points, 2, 5 on a 2D plane. Another set of points are 4, 9, controversial looking line.
Yeah.
Sure. There's a G.
So, what was the equation that Miss Susan kindly...
Y equals mx plus c.
Y equals mx plus c.
Don't make me leave again.
Don't make me leave. So the M represents the...
The gradient, Monte. Mountains,
Monte,
climbing.
Climbing steep.
And the C represents...
The Y intercept.
Where it clashes into there. Okay. So, we, with this set of 2 points, we can actually work out the gradient, which is the steepness of the line. How would we do that? So let's say working out the gradient using those 2 points.
The way you showed us was to take the difference in Y.
So the difference in Y. So the change, that's the change in the Y.
Yeah.
Over the?
The change in X.
The change. So that little triangle, we can use it as a change.
Cool.
And what's the change?
That's the
change in Y.
Okay, it goes from 5 to 9. So that's changes 4.
9 minus 5, 4.
Minus 5, which is 4.
Yeah.
I'm changing the 4, this is controversial. And then the change in the X
is 4 minus 2.
4 minus 2, which is 2, and 4 divided by 2.
That's going to be 2. So m is 2.
And the gradient is 2. Wow. So we go back to the equation. We do what we call plugging in. Y equals 2x. This is Eagle's finest classroom.
Sorry, sir.
So
math
bands.
Oh, God. Yeah, math bands. 2x plus... See, got carried away there. 2x
plus
c.
Perfect, okay.
So, we've got this, but it's not quite full,
yeah.
Complete, because we're missing what the y-intercept is. We know how steep it is now. How steep is this? What's the steepness as it were?
2.
Gradient 2.
Yeah,
2. So, we can use either of these points and substitute them like a football team. Get them onto the pitch. Get the final result. So, who are we going to substitute?
2, 5.
Yeah,
2, 5.
Nice and simple, yeah.
So, y is what in this one?
5.
So 5 equals
2 times x, so 2 times 2 is 4.
4 plus c. So what's Mr. C going to be?
Oh, to take 4 over both sides. C is equal to 1.
Has to be 1, yeah.
C equals 1. And then what do we do for the final pièce de la résistance?
Plug it in.
Y equals
2x plus 1.
And then it even works with 4 and 9.
So try it. So 9.
It's 2 times 4 is 8 plus 1.
Boom. Peace out.
Drop the chalk.
Thank you very much, Susan, for your amazing lesson. aren't straight lines. Linear equations. Gradients, climbing, monte. I'm never going to forget the French word for climbing. No, this is good. So what I'm going to do is take your brilliant knowledge you've given to us and apply it to finding a route around a treasure map.
Ooh.
So I have found a treasure map in my attic.
This guy.
And and this treasure map is actually set on a graph.
Ooh.
Ooh, gosh.
And it looks like the following. So we have, we start at 0, 0.
Sure.
At the origin. So let's add some, let's be clear, let's add some labels. And now on the treasure map, you can't just go straight to the treasure.
Okay.
It'd be too easy. Right? We know where X marks the spot, right? That's over here at 7, 0.
Yeah. Sure.
So we know where the treasure is, but it's locked in a sealed chest. So before we can get to the treasure, we've got to pick up the key. And the key is up here at 3, 4.
Ooh.
So here's the key. And the key is guarded by an evil witch. There's a witch's hat.
Mm.
And the witch will only give you the key if you solve the riddle carved into the stone on the side of the mountain. This is a whole, this is a good treasure map. It's a good treasure hunt. And the stone on the side of the mountain is at 1, 2. So this is our sort of mountain and riddle written in mountain. I'm good at art.
Yeah.
Okay, so what we need to do is starting from the origin, we need to move, first of all, to here.
Yeah, first line.
Then we need to move the second line up to give the solution of the riddle to the witch to get the key.
Mm-hmm.
And then we've got to go down and use the key to unlock the treasure chest. Now to do this, we need to know the equations of our lines. We need to know exactly the direction that we're going to move in. So first of all, starting from the origin, we need to go to here to solve the riddle. So in what direction, what is the equation for
okay,
this
line?
So we need to work out.
So the y equals mx plus c. It's not going to get take off, is it?
I've got you, Bobby.
Spotify link. Y.
So y equals mx plus c. So we need to find, first of all, what's our c?
It's a zero.
Zero.
Good,
okay.
Yeah.
And then, so to get the gradient, you want the change in y divided by the change in x. So our height is 2, and then our change in x is 1. So it's m is equal to 2 over 1, so our gradient is just 2.
So our equation
y equals
just
2x.
So starting off from our current location, we have to walk along the line y equals 2x.
Cool.
Right. So we get the riddle. Bobby, what's the riddle?
What starts off on 4 legs?
4 legs.
Moves to 2 legs.
2 legs.
Ends up on 3 legs.
3 legs.
Riddle be this, riddle be that.
4 to 2 to 3.
I'm clueless. I'm just going to start calculating where we're going next.
Okay.
Susan, you can work on that one.
We'll get there at the end. We'll get there at the end.
So we have a little bit of time because we've got to travel from the mountain with the stone where the riddle is carved to the witch.
Right.
To exchange the answer for the key. So we need to go from 1, 2 to 3, 4. And now probably want to use Bobby's method now, don't we? Because we have 2 points.
2 points!
So, what is that equation between those 2 points?
Okay, so we don't have a y-intercept. We find that after. So we need to find the gradient first.
Yeah, so for the gradient, we'll work out the change in the y over the change in the x.
Yes.
So change in the y is 4 minus 2.
Which is 2.
And the change in the x is?
3 minus 1, which is 2, so the gradient is 1.
Perfect.
Divided by 2, 1, yeah.
So the gradient is 1.
So, and then to find out what the c is, we substitute our values into y equals x.
Plus c.
Yeah.
We'll try the easier one, we'll try the 1, 2.
Yeah.
So the y is 2.
Yeah.
2 equals mx, which is 1,
one times 1.
Plus c, so 2 equals 1 plus c. Between C is?
1.
Yeah.
Perfect.
So Y equals X
plus 1.
And does that work with our new point?
So 4 is equal to 3 plus 1. Yes.
Perfect. Right. So we've gone along Y equals 2X. Then we've travelled along Y equals X plus 1. And now
Do we have the solution?
I've got no idea what this is.
We're relying on you here, Bobby.
to three. Is it an old person?
Yeah, it was a person. Yeah.
So it's a baby crawling, adult walking, and then someone like...
Walking stick.
Yeah. So we have unlocked the riddle.
Okay, right, fantastic. So we can exchange the riddle. We've got the key from the witch.
Bye, witch.
And now we need to get down to here, don't we?
Oh, yes.
Right.
So this, coming back to the end of your lesson, Susan, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
So how are we going to do this one?
What type of line is this one, yo?
It's a negative gradient.
Okay, so, again, it's still the same idea though, isn't it? We're going to do the gradient. So a change in y, we've gone from 4 to 0. So we've taken away 4.
Mm-hmm.
Divided by...
So it's minus 4 on the top part.
Okay. Wait a minute. And then we've gone from... 3 to 7, so we've added on 4. Yep, so then our gradient is minus 1.
Very good.
Okay.
So we now know that y is equal to minus x.
Plus c.
Plus c.
Plug in our values. This is 7, 0, isn't it?
Yeah.
So 7 is that. Minus x plus what gives us 0?
7.
Yeah.
7. Perfect. So we start off, y equals 2x.
First part.
We solve Bobby's riddle. It's a human. We give the answer to the witch, we get the key, we go on our negative gradient, y equals minus x plus 7. We open the treasure chest.
We're rich!
We're rich,
yeah. We're done.
Amazing.
Oh, math is beautiful.